hit the ground. When I wake up, I wanna sing and shout for every blessing and good thing that you do. I know that it's true, and so I'm gonna choose.
Hey, OKids, Pastor Alberto here. I'm so excited to be here with you today, and I'm so thankful for it. And that's exactly what we're going to be learning about all November long, is how to be thankful and that we can thank God for everything, especially for our families. It's fall, and we get to hang out with them. And there's a memory verse that I want us to remember all month long. Can you follow after me? Do like Simon says, okay? Here we go. I will thank the Lord with all my heart. Psalm 111, 1. That's it. And that's awesome. That's the word of God. So I want you to remember that, okay? As we go on and learn this next Bible story, I want you to stay hooked up. One more thing. Keep a lookout for this GIF that's coming up. It's going to be a special GIF. You got to keep track and find out where it is, okay? It's going to be sometime for this, during this whole message. So I'll see you at the end.
Good morning, Overcomer Kids. Hi, this is Miss Alicia, and today we have another true Bible story that talks about two special friends. So the first friend is David. David was a shepherd, and that means he took care of all the sheep in the yard. And he did a really good job at that. Then the next friend we're gonna talk about today is John. His name is Jonathan, but for today we're gonna say John, okay? He was the son of a king. So he lived in a really big palace. He had to have he got to carry a sword with him, wore a really, really fancy belt, and he wore a robe that was really fancy in that time to be living in the palace and wearing those things. Well, David and John were really, really good friends. They got to do a lot of things together. They got to walk together. They spent a lot of time together. They even sat down and ate dinner together. Can you imagine that? So, David's outside taking care of the sheep. Not really fancy, might be a little bit muddy. John's in the palace, dressed in a robe and everything. But they became really good friends. Isn't that amazing how you can be from two different places and work in two different jobs and be the best of friends? That's awesome, right? So, one day, John decided that he was so thankful for the good friend that David was that he gave him his sword and his robe and his fancy belt. Can you imagine how grateful David was? Like, I've never worn robes like this. I've never had a sword. I've never had a belt like this. John was so grateful for David's friendship that he allowed him to wear those things. And they were really happy about that. So, what can we do to show God that we are thankful for our friends? Any suggestions? Okay. That all sounds really good. One thing you can do is say like, hey, I like your shoes, or your hair is pretty. Oh, that's a nice haircut, man. or I like your book bag, or your shirt's really nice. So let's try some of those things. Can we say, like, I like your hair.
I like your hair.
I like your shoes.
I like your shoes.
That's very kind things to say that we can say to our friends. God wants us to be kind to one another so that we can be good friends like David and Jonathan. Even though David was a shepherd and Jonathan was in the palace and did fancy things where David didn't get to do that, they still came together and became really good friends. So God wants us to do the same thing with our friends, no matter where you come from. Be nice to one another and be good friends. The bottom line is we can thank God for everything, right? Even good friends. You might not think about it that often, but we are blessed to have really good friends in our life. So we can thank God for that. Okay, guys, did you get the lesson for today? Being a good friend is awesome. No matter what walk of life that you're on, just be a good friend to everybody. And we're going to go over the memory verse for today. And it comes from the book of Psalm, chapter 111, verse 1. I'll say that again. It comes from Psalms, chapter 111, verse 1. I will give thanks to the Lord with my whole heart. Come on, guys, say it with me again. Psalms 111 and 1. I will give thanks to the Lord with my whole heart. Okay, guys, if we can get into our prayer postures, we're going to pray ourselves out today. God, thank you for your loving us and giving us good friends. Help us to be good friends and share with those that are around us. We love you, God. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Thank you, guys, for being good listeners and for, remember, being a good friend. Have a great day.
All right, welcome, kids. We're here. Get ready to start our basketball challenge for the month of November. Now, it's going to be really exciting. We got two challengers here, and it's going to be amazing. By the way, my name is Mr. Darrell. Are you ready to have fun? I said, are you ready to have fun? All right. So, week one in November, we have our free throw challenge. All right, to my right. Wait, which side is my right? Right? I think this is my right. Over here on my right, we have Mr. Dimitri Hale from, no pun intended, Dimitri Hale from Milwaukee. Yeah. Challenger number one. All right, challenger number two to my left. If this is my right, this has to be my left. To my left, we have Brittany from North Carolina. Yeah. All right. So now, since November is the 11th, month of the year, we're gonna go to 11 points. So here's the challenge. You guys ready?
Oh,
all right. So you have to hit 11 free throws in a row. That means if you miss, you have to start back at zero.
All right, move.
All right, so let's see who can hit 11 free throws in a row without missing. And the best part about this is you can participate. Send us a video of you and your free throw challenge and we'll air you live on OKids Live. Isn't that incredible? All right, let's get started with the challenge.
I'll let you go first. You were supposed to go first. You were contender number one. You ready first. All right. Ladies first. Thank you.
Nice.